Good evening, everyone. Myself, Ragini Mishra, Assistant Professor from Sri L.R. Tiwari College of Engineering. Today, the topic that I'm going to introduce is Artificial Intelligence. Before discussing Artificial Intelligence, let us discuss what is intelligence. Intelligence is nothing but an ability of a system to compute, reason, perceive, relationship, and learn from experience. Store and retrieve the information from memory, solve problems, comprehend complex ideas, use natural language easily, classify them, generalize them, and adapt to a new situation. Now, basically, when we talk about intelligence, the intelligence is composed of five stuff. First one is reasoning, second is learning, third is perception, fourth is problem solving, fifth one is linguistic intelligence. Let us see what is reasoning. Reasoning is a set of processes that enable us to provide basis for judgment, making decisions and predictions. Whereas when we talk about learning, it is the activity of gaining knowledge or skill by studying, practicing, being taught or experiencing something. Next, the problem solving. The problem solving is nothing but a process in which one perceives and tries to arrive at a desired solution from present situation by taking some path which is blocked by known or unknown hurdles. Problem solving also includes decision making, which is a process of selecting the best suitable alternative out of the multiple alternatives to reach the desired goal that are available for a solution. Next, perception. Perception is a process of acquiring, interpreting, selecting, and organizing the sensory's information. Perception presumes the sensing, the quality that a human has. In human, perception is aided by a sensory organ. In the domain of AI, perception mechanism puts the data acquired by the sensors together in a meaningful manner. Let's discuss the last point, but not the least one, that is linguistic intelligence. Linguistic intelligence is an ability to use, comprehend, speak, and write the verbal and written languages. It is important in interpersonal communication. That's what about the intelligence was. Now let us come to the topic that we are supposed to discuss, that is, what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is said to be a branch of computer science that deals with the simulation of intelligent behavior in computer. It is a capability of a machine to imitate intelligent human behavior. Actually, when we talk about the central principles of AI, it includes reasoning, knowledge, planning, learning, communication, perception, and the ability to move and manipulate the objects. Now, AI comprises of certain methods which are being broadly categorized as two. The first one is symbolic AI and the next one is computational AI. When we talk about a symbolic AI, that focuses on development of the knowledge-based system where we put all our experience to a knowledge base, and this knowledge base is further used to analyze how the system will respond once it is under a supervised control. Computational AI. It includes methods like neural network, fuzzy system, and evolutionary computing, where it deals with more of nodes and analyzing the nodes. Now, we'll check out some terms which are very much important when we are supposed to discuss AI. The first one is agent and its environment, percept and percept sequence, agent function, agent program. Let us have a look what is an agent first. An agent is anything that can perceive its environment through sensors and act upon the environment through effectors. Now, we have certain agents like human agent, robotic agent, and software agents. When we talk about a human agent has a sensory organs such as eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin, parallel to the sensors, and other organs such as hands, leg, mouth, for effectors. So here you can understand the effectors are nothing but the response the thing that can respond is nothing but an effector. The robotic agent replaces the cameras and infrared range finders for the sensors and various motors and actuators for the effectors. Now, software agent, when you talk about, software agent has encoded bit string as its program and action. Here we utilize our knowledge-based system. Entire knowledge is fed in a form of a program to a robot, and then robot in a sequence that it has in his history, it acts accordingly. Now, for example, I'll give you, if we are supposed to do an internet shopping. In internet shopping, the agent would be internet shopping agent. The sensors here would be the HTML and DHTML pages that are being displayed. And actuators will be form that are displayed to the user. Now, let's discuss what are its environment. Environment, we have six types of environment that can be. The first one is discrete continuous, observable, partially observable, static, dynamic, single agent, multi-agent, deterministic, non-deterministic, episodic, non-episodic. Now let us see what are discrete and continuous are. If there are limited number of distinct, clearly defined state of an environment, the environment is discrete. The example for it would be a chess. Otherwise, it's continuous, that is a driving. Next, observable and partially observable. If it is possible to determine the complete state of the environment at each time point, from percept, it is observable. Otherwise, it is only partially observable. Static, dynamic. If the environment doesn't change while an agent is acting, then it is static. Otherwise, it's dynamic. Single agent, multi-agent. The environment may contain other agents which may be of same or different kind as that of the agent. Okay, so that's how single and multiple agents are. Deterministic and non-deterministic. If this next state of the environment is completely determined by the current state and the action of agent, then the environment is deterministic. Otherwise, it is non-deterministic. Episodic versus non-episodic. In an environment of episodic, each episode consists of agent perceiving and then acting. The quality of its action depend on the episode itself. Subsequent episode do not depend on the actions in the previous episode. So episodic environments are much simpler because the agent do not need to think ahead. That's how it was about environment. Let us check for the next point, that is percept. And what is percept sequence? When we talk about a percept is nothing but an agent's perceptual input at any given instant. For example, a boiler's temperature at particular time, at a particular instant of time, that is a percept. But when I say percept sequence, so it is a complete history of everything that agent has perceived. For example, if I have a robotic agent who is continuously monitoring the temperature of the boiler, who is continuously sensing the temperature of the boiler, that is a percept sequence. Now, let us discuss what is agent function. Now, agent function is a mathematical function which maps each and every possible percept sequence to a possible action. For example, an ATM machine. ATM machine releases money only once when you follow the procedure that it is shown on the screen. That is how ATM machine is showing a function, showing a functionality of agent function, how it behaves. When you say agent program, it is to develop agent program. We tabulate all the agent function that are being described by the agent, and we put bound to length of percept sequence that we need to consider. Else my search will go too vague, so I have to restrict myself to certain limitation. So that's how the agent program is about. Now, let's see the component of AI. We have discussed much about agents, so let us discuss what the architecture is about. But the agent is nothing but it combines of architecture. It is a combination of architecture plus the program. So architecture is nothing but a machinery that an agent executes on, that is a platform that it provides. Whereas program is implementation of an agent function. That is a mathematical aspect that you have suggested or that you have designed for your percept sequence. That is your program. Now, next, let us discuss the application of AI. Now, when it comes to an application of AI, many of us are aware about many upcoming technologies. The one of the most recent one is robotics and AI combination, the first application, which says that you have an intelligent humanoid, Sophia, which has been developed by Hong Kong-based company Hansen Robotics. The good quality of this Sophia is she responds to every question that you want to ask. It is very intelligent system. All types of data are being fed to it. You ask any kind of data to her, any question to her, she will immediately respond to her, whether it be a sad, happy, or any kind of talk. She will definitely do it to you. Even she can react to the situation if you are saying something good or you are saying something bad or which is not happy kind of. So in the world, in the October 2017, the robot became a Saudi Arabian citizen, the first robot to receive the citizenship of any country. So this is one of the very good application which has come up as a combination of robotics and AI. Now the second one is medicine. A medical clinic can use artificial intelligence system to organize bed schedules, make a staff rotation, and provide medical informations. AI has also application in the field of cardiology, neurology, embryology, complex operations of internal organs also. The next one, heavy industries. The huge machines involve risk of their manual maintenance and working. So it becomes sometimes necessary to have an efficient and safe operation agent in their operation. So here we can have a robots or we can have an AI-based system which will automatically monitor the system and will handle the heavy industry, heavy work which are to be carried out. Telecommunication, many communication companies make use of heuristic search in the management of their workforce. For example, BT Group has deployed a heuristic search in the scheduling application that provides the work schedule of 20,000 engineers. So this is one of the good application of telecommunication in terms of AI. Next, music. Scientists are trying to make the computer emulate the activity of skillful musicians. Composition performance, music theory, and sound processing are some of the major areas on which research in music and artificial intelligence are focusing on. For example, you can say Chucks, Orchestra, Smart Music. These are some of the companies which are coming up with the application using the AI for music. Next, last but not least one, that is gaming. In the earlier days, the gaming technology was not broadened, but physicist Willy Higginbotham created the first video game in 1958. It was called Tennis for Two and was plan oscilloscope. But now AI technology has become vast and standards has also been increased. So now you know some games like Sudoku, Fear, Fallout, etc. And many more games are there which are using AI as a platform to be executed. Thank you so much.